Good afternoon and welcome back to The Hangar. Today we're going to talk about the propulsion of my crazy giant C-47. Thank you to Zor Propellers for sponsoring and supporting this project by donating the propellers. These things are crazy. So I'm going to talk about them a little bit more and talk about Zor a little bit. And they also sent me a pretty cool, like, production manufacturing video, not of these props, but like of their facilities in general, and shows like their technology and what they do. It's pretty impressive. Maybe that's already running right now over the top of my voice. They have over 40 years of experience making propellers for hobby RC, everything from powered paragliders to big UAVs, small RC, everything in between, manned stuff and unmanned. They have got an impressive operation. It's really, really cool. So I am super excited to have them on board providing the propulsion for my project. This is a 30 by 12, so that's 30 inch diameter and 12 inch pitch. This is their World War II like style version of the propellers. It's three blade. And so it comes already painted with the black blades and the yellow tips and the whole deal. Normally these are for gas, but I'm using basically 150cc gas equivalent motor. Plus they're just freaking awesome propellers. So I just had to ask. And so I'm so happy that they said yes. You'll notice in the middle here, there is just one hole. Now my mount is a hex pattern. That's it right here. This is the sort of top plate that holds the propeller on the motor. So I've got six in a pattern here. So I'm going to use this to make a perfect pattern, you know, on the propeller, and using a drill press or something stable like that, I will be drilling those six holes into the propeller so that they are perfectly centered and, you know, yeah, so that's all good. Okay, now for the motor. I know I showed you the motor in the last video, but I wasn't super clear. So we're going to show you the motor right now. I'm not pretending. Well, okay, I'm a little bit. This is the motor. It's a beast. It was donated by a friend of mine who wishes to remain anonymous. So thank you, anonymous friend. But it also has no markings on it. So I really don't know exactly what it is. But I do know what it looks like. It looks like Eternagy Rotomax 150. Now, I haven't counted the coils or anything like that, so I'm not sure precisely. But that's sort of the class motor that we're in. So what I did to try and figure out what am I dealing with here is I got a laser tachometer. And what that does is it measures the actual RPM of this guy by measuring how many times this little reflective strip turns around. And by doing that, I measured and calculated that this is a roughly 110 kV motor. That's a really low kV. The lowest I've ever run or seen in my own personal life is the Monster motor, actually, which is a 510 kV. Very close to that in low numbers is the motor on the Edge over there, which is a 550 kV. But 110 kV, that is freakishly low for me. Using that number, I was able to use eCalc. I'll put a link to that. That's a super great program. If you don't already have a subscription to that, I highly, highly recommend it. It's really useful and it's super cheap. And with that, you can do calculations for propellers or EDFs, batteries, the whole nine yards. It's really useful. So using eCalc, I was able to plug in my 110 kV motor and the battery system that I am planning on using, which is going to be a 12S. This will go up a lot higher than that, but 12S is in the range that I can realistically, you know, afford and fit on here, and also charge and all the things. So using 12S and this motor, that is where I came up with my spec'd numbers for the 30 by 12. I could go up to like 34 by maybe 10, but then that gets into some crazy current draw amp numbers, and I just don't want to go there. Also, that then upsizes your batteries, which increases your weight. And one of the main thrusts of this project, no pun intended, no pun achieved either, is to keep the weight down below 55 pounds. Because if I can do that, then I don't need the AMA waiver and I can fly this at Rocket City RC, which would be awesome. So that's it. That's the prop. Thank you, Zor. This has been a dream come true to actually get these things. They're beautiful. And I just can't wait to put these on a motor and run some tests. We will definitely do some static run tests long before I probably even have an airframe finished or halfway started. But we will rig this up onto a test bench stand and put the props on it, and we'll do some actual thrust testing and RPM testing and amp current draw testing and see what we're actually dealing with. While we're talking about motors and power systems, I might as well also mention the speed controller that we're going to use on this project. And it also is donated along with the motors. Thank you, anonymous friend. It is a Jetty Spin 300. It's a pretty beefy piece of kit here. That's a lot of ESC. 300 amp, we're not going to be anywhere near that. It could go up to 14 cell, but we're going to keep it at 12 just for sanity and safety sake, at least to start. But it's good to know that if we do want to, take these motors and put them on something else in the future, we could go up to 14S. So that will do it for today. Thanks again, Zor, for donating and supporting this project with these awesome, super cool props. And thank all of you for watching and hanging out with me in the hangar. We'll see you next time. Bye.